Mano Kaina. This is my beach. This is where I grew up, and this is where I learned how to bodyboard. Hi, I'm Ryan Mahalo, and this is my hometown of Kauai. As you can see out there, it's no walk in the park. This is some serious business, and I've been training all my life to do this.
Are you ever scared of sharks?
Nah, sharks don't scare me.
Does anything scare you?
Nothing scares me. Failure, that's about it.
What was the scariest moment out there?
The scariest moment is I was out on the beach one time and I was about to catch a wave and I saw a fin. I thought it was a shark. It scared the crap out of me.
What was it?
Oh, it was just a dolphin. Alright. Let's roll. Basically, it's simple. Here's my bodyboard. What you do is you just place your hands however you want to cut. If you want to cut left hands first. If you want to cut right hands first. And then, you know, once you feel the wave push you, guys, I don't know if you want to be around here too long. It gets pretty heavy.
So what does it feel like?
What do you mean, to be number one? Feels pretty good. Not number one yet, though. Actually, I had a pretty tough childhood growing up, you know? Trying to bodyboard around Maury, he was pretty good. All these other guys, they didn't think I had it in me. They'd always push me around, take my bodyboard away from me. You know, call me white boy. I'm the only white Hawaiian left. There used to be a lot more of us, but they just went somewhere else, I don't know. First time I stepped on a boogie board when I was about 14 months old, I was actually roaming on the beach. My mom started doing something else and she lost track of me, and when she found me, I was laying on top of someone's boogie board. And that's when we knew that, you know, it was just something I was gonna do the rest of my life. Oh, well, I don't really make money right now. Not in those stages yet. I would consider myself a pro, even though you have to make money to be pro. But I'd still consider myself a pro. I don't know yet. And I'm still trying to figure that one out, basically. Every day, every dang day. Now there's not a day I'm not out here. I dropped out of high school because I love boogie boarding so much. I didn't do that good in high school anyway, so that's kind of why I dropped out too. But, well, actually I was kicked out of school, but that's a different story. It's not about riding waves, it's about being a wave. Well, have you guys ever seen the movie Point Break, the edited version? Yeah, you know how that guy on the very end, he dies riding a wave. I hope I drown riding a wave.
Now listen, how do you deal with all these rocks? I know some of the beaches can be rocky or, you know, coraline.
Oh, no. You don't bodyboard here, dude. No, that's unheard of. Don't worry about it. I basically, run the beach, I run up hills, I throw logs, I spend a little time in the weight room, and swim.
100.
does anyone?
Yep.
Have you ever been stung by a jellyfish?
Never. No. But my friend did, and I had to pee on it. Yeah. It was gross.
How long do you watch the waves before you go out there?
20 minute minimum. Once that 20 minute buzzer goes off, I'm in the water. And I'm not coming out for probably 3-4 hours. No. Maybe to put more sunscreen on. But nothing else will get me out. If I see a shark, I might come out. But I'm not afraid of sharks. One time I got caught in a really bad rip current. I actually could stand up in the water, but it took me about 45 minutes to get back. And no one else I could see was really caught in it. But when it took me that long to get back in, I knew it was a rip current. My boogie board's actually my pillow, believe it or not. My pillow.
So how tough do you have to be to ride these waves?
I don't know. You know, this is always a question that makes me a little uneasy because you have to be pretty tough. You know, you can't just go out there without training. I mean, you have to train for these things. But you know what bugs me? It's people that think you can train for big wave boogie boarding. Can't, you know? It's just it's a real big misconception that people have. Man, that's probably the sweetest experience, is getting caught in the tube, getting caught in the curl of a wave. That's just some experience that many people won't have during their lifetime. You know, I feel sorry for them. I really do. You know, I don't even know what I'm doing here. But I'm here, and I'm doing it, and I'm giving it my best. I'm kind of a big deal. What do you say we go hit some waves?
All right, let's go.
Should I train?
Soldier boy, tough. Hey, I got this new damn for y'all called a soldier boy. You got a punch, then crank back 3 times.
Ain't no playground. Where are you from?
Arizona.
Yeah, this ain't like the beaches in Arizona. I think today I definitely caught the biggest air that I've ever caught in my life. Today was a huge milestone for me. Did a lot of things I've never done before, and I'm glad that you guys are here to witness that. I got sand in my eyes.